think about the topic of istishfaq bin dawa and raja sahib bin mu'alajah bin fadah.
So, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nur Hidayah binti Muhammad Farid, matric number 115-1882. So, I will be explaining to a few about the introduction. So, as we know, Islam is very concerned with goodness and health. In terms of health, Muslims are required to maintain their health, and Islam also asks the Muslim to find any solution or to treat in order to cure their illness that infect them. So Allah has stated in Surah Al-Isra ayah 82, which means, and we reveal of the Quran that which is a healing and a mercy to the believers, and it adds only to the perdition of the unjust. In Hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam state that for every disease there is the medicine. Then when the medicine is suitable for a disease, it will be healed. Bismillah. So definitely my fellow friend know what is medicine, right?
Yes.
So medicine is medicational materials for diagnosing, treatment, healing, preventing the disease in human and improving their health status. So in our research, we'll be focusing on the medicine which contains any illegal substance for Muslim in medicational field, and the possibility for Muslim to consume any kind of medicine in order to cure their illness. So before we speak further about our research, I want to clarify to all of you about the conditions for medicine which is allowed or halal for Muslim to consume. So first, the first condition is it must not contain any substance from animal that are haram, which is not slaughtered according to Shara. Second, it does not contain material which is unclean in accordance with Islamic law. And third, it is safe to be taken, non-toxic, non-destructive, and not harmful to health. And the last one is it is not prepared or processed using contaminated equipment in accordance with Islamic law.
My name is Aswanita Bintak Bijama, matric number 115-1843. So I want to explain about the, I want to give the examples of medicine which contain peat, which contain the element of peat, or in medication too, because we call it as swine. Okay, there are two medicines that we found which contain swine, the element of peat, which is first is cladribine and second is fraxiparine. Okay, these two medicine has been used in medicational field in order to prevent blood clotting. Usually they are using during surgery. Okay, and according to according to Islamic law, during the Sharia, cladribine and fraxiparine cannot be used in curing the patient because it is produced from the prohibited sources. Okay, that's an element of swine. And furthermore, these past 10 years, the studies have found that another medicine which has the same function as well as cladribine and fraxiparine that can be used to help prevent blood clotting problem, which is erythra. So there is no reason for the doctors to use cladribine and fraxiparine anymore in order to cure the patient. When nowadays they already provide another medicine which is called erythra, and it is free from any peat elements of peat. Okay, and in erythra, the solution is called fondaparinux. Fondaparinux, which is the solution in erythra. The solution is used to inject the patient. And usually, as I said before, you during surgery in order to prevent blood clotting. So, So we cannot see there's any reason at all for the doctors to use triazine and fluoxetine as it is contained the harmful the haram substance. Okay, that is all from me. Thank you.
Okay, my name is Safifa binti Rafli, number 5, 1818. And here's I'm going to discuss about the prohibited substances. I'm going to discuss about some of the medicines and the bad effects of it, which contain prohibited substances. Okay, prohibited substances in medicines is defined as intoxicants, harmful to health, and also contain any animal or human body parts. Okay, such as body parts of the intestine derived from there, gelatin. Gelatin is widely used in cheesecake, so be careful when you eat cheesecake. Okay. First of all, Adderall. Adderall is very common to treat ADHD. ADHD is attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. It is a disorder, mental disorder, very, very common among the children, among the kids, and it can be continued until the adulthood. Okay, and this kind of disorder is means that the kids are very hyper and can't control themselves in any normal behavior. They are very active and very super energetic. So Adderall is here to cure the ADHD, but somehow Adderall can make them lose self-control and can cause insomnia. Insomnia, you know insomnia, what?
Yes. Okay.
And then they can cause a decreased reaction time that they can sometimes of lacking in giving you a faster reaction. And also, I forgot to tell you that Adderall contains narcotic drugs. Narcotic drugs are usually morphines and heroines. You know, morphines and heroines are drugs that is very, very dangerous and also prohibited, right? So, we are going to the second medicine, which is quicksand. Quicksand can cause coughing blood, paralysis, and shortness of breath. And the third one, praziparine. Praziparine, as Aspaniza has explained, it can prevent blood clots, but somehow it can lead to formation of blood clot in the legs, in the blood vessels, and sometimes the blood clot can travel to the lungs and also can cause shortness of breath, sometimes something like that, and it can cause death. Okay, we are going to the final medicines. Medicines associated with alcohol can cause nauseous, vomiting, loss of coordination, and also fainting, something like that. And we all know that alcohol is prohibited in our religion, right? So there's some of the bad effects of prohibited substances in the medicines. Thank you.
So hi, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Hazwani Binti Hazil, and my gender number is 1151819. So I'm going to continue about this discussion. For my point is current issue of the legal substances in medicine. So, from my view, I've come up with the three main points, which is the current issue, which is the past 2 years that occurred in Malaysia, on 13 October 2015 at Manjung Perak. The issue is a ban of ethanol product from rice. So, in this incident is, the medicine type of ethanol from product of rice was banned due to high level amount of alcohol. The thing is, this matter happened in the first place, the ethanol is kind of paracetamol. Paracetamol is used for fever, high fever, and so on. So, the paracetamol, which is the ethanol type, which was allowed by Jabatan Kesihatan Malaysia at first. But after several or some examine onwards, the result showed that in that particular ethanol, which is the paracetamol, has contained the high level of alcohol. So, according to JKM, this matter will cause harm to the patient, especially for the kids. Because the kid who is still early age. So, the level of alcohol that contained in that ethanol was forbidden and disallowed in hospital. Thus, the ethanol was banned from entering to Malaysia. So the second, I come out with the reason why this thing happened in Malaysia. So basically, the first main reason why this issue quite happened in the Malaysia is because the medicine itself using the scientific term. Okay, the term which for citizen hard to recognize the scientific term for the medicine itself. So because the term of medicine name is mostly came from scientific term, which may be quite hard to recognize the scientific term of medicine. The issue in this matter will arise because certain peoples, specifically Malaysian, we do not really recognize or we don't really know about the scientific term of the medicine itself. So, for instance, the medicine which contains porcine, which has been discussed from them, which the porcine itself means the part of antibody of swine. So, in addition, for some paracetamol, also it might contain amount of alcohol. People must aware with those terms of medicine to avoid and to prevent any harmful circumstances. So the second reason is the using medication, using medicine without consultation from doctor and pharmacist. So in this thing, people who lack of awareness or concern of this issue, mostly the people who took the medicine without the consultation from the doctors and pharmacists. Which is, in taking any medicine, the advice from the doctor and pharmacist is very important. Otherwise, it may lead to any harmful incident or unwanted things may happen. So, in this particular issue, the irresponsible party may be insert some illegal substances in medicine, which without consideration to the Muslim. So, if the Muslim must be aware and alert about the every dose medicine before taking it for the final time.
Alright, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Amin Faridi bin Samsudin and my metric number is 1151837. Alright, I will be proceeding with the question of fatwa of istishfa bin dawak and najasa fil mu'ayyad. Okay, there are basically five sources which we gathered to find out the fatwa of this matter. Okay, the first four sources basically says that it is not permissible to take medicine from any haram substances, only if it is darurat. Okay, Imam Atiyah Sakar, which is one of the Imam in Mesir, he said that Jumhur said medication with Al-Khamar is haram without compromise. Then healing with Najis other than Al-Khamar only permissible when it is darurat. In a hadith, it is stated that Khamar is not a medicine but a disease. And then there was a question whether urine is also included into najis or not. Okay, Sheikh Itiyah Sakar said that all najis is considered as all urine are considered as najis because of its uncleanliness. But one of Rasulullah's hadith said that only the urine of camel is permissible to use for medicine. Alright, in kitab Quratul Aini bil Fatawa Ulama Haramai, it is stated from the fifth source, which is Mausu'ah Fiqhiyah Kuwaitiyah, the Fuqaha had agreed that it is not permissible to cure with prohibited things and also najis, based on a hadith Inna Allah lam yaj'al shifa'akum fima harrama alaykum, which means Allah doesn't created any shifa, any cure for you from any haram substances. And also, Inna Allah anzala dawa wa dawa, which means that Allah had created a disease, come with medication or a medicine. Alright, Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu once wrote a letter to Khalid al-Walid. He said that I heard you had used al-khamar to cure yourself. He also said that Allah had prohibited khamar itself. Allah also prohibits us to hold it as well as to drink it, and do not use it to your body as it is considered as najis. Alright, the Malikiyah said that it is haram to use anything that is created from khamar for medication, and also it is haram to use dead bodies as our medication. Either it is used in the sense of drinking it or applying it to your body, or mixing it with any haram substances, it is also haram. But if it is darurat, all of it is permissible. The Hanbali said that it is haram to use najis as medicine. Medicine, alcohol, all urine cannot be used as medication except the urine of camels. Hanafiya says that it is permissible to use haram medicine or najis only if we know that medicine or substances can really cure, and only whenever there is no halal medicine to use. And the Shafi'iyya stated that if the najis or prohibited things are pure najis, or in the pure sense of it, then the hukum is haram to use it. But if it is mixed with any halal things, it can be used as medication with two conditions. First one is the doctor must really be of knowledge, although he is fasik. And the second one, if by using the prohibited medicine, it will speed up the process of curing the disease. And that's all from me. We conclude our presentation with Assalamualaikum.
Not yet.
The statistic.
So I will continue. And last but not least, before we conclude our presentation today, I want to share all of you about the statistic that we made. We made according to our research, which is about the usage of any body part of swine in the food, medicine, and cosmetic. As we can see here, all of you see this?
Yes.
Okay, so the 26% from this statistic is contains collagen and elastin, which used in making food, soap, milk, and toothpaste. The other 40%, which is porcine, is used in making the medicine, which the specific is the plexin and fraxiparin. So that the many that we use is the usage is 60% of gelatin, which commonly used in making foods. So that's all from this. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.